Morning, everybody. John Swift here. I am standing on US 41. It's a bit brisk today, that's why I got my jacket on. US 41 near the airport, Sarasota. Maybe I'm just over the Manatee line, actually. Technically, I am in Manatee County. All right. Technically, I'm in Manatee County. The Sarasota line is right down there. And I'm at this place called... Sorry, it's windy. I hope it doesn't mess up the sound here. But I'm at a place called Gold Sauna, and this is freaking me out. Let's get a look at this building real quick. I'm a little freaked out right now. See, it says open right there. Right there in the window, it says open. But there's not one car in the parking lot. It's kind of weirding me out. So you go up here, it says parking in the back. And then it looks like there's a wreath on the door, so it looks like maybe that, you know, it's recent. It says open, please come in on the sign right there next to the door. Hi. Hi. How's it going? The lady actually just peeked out of the door. Why didn't I shoot that? Now she's going to call the police, probably. Okay, so here's what's freaking me out. There's not one car in the parking lot, okay? I'm trying to figure out how to put this. Okay, so I go in the back. There's not one car in the parking lot. So where do they park? Do they park? Do they get dropped off? So there is a lot of things in Sarasota called these saunas. And I've heard from other people, okay, that you go into these saunas and they're like a massage place, but they actually do more than massage, if you know what I mean. They do extracurricular massage things, and it's kind of in a weird space. A lot of these places are up here by the airport for some reason. I think there's something where the police have been cracking down on these places because, you know, what they do is illegal. And in the city, they've been doing so. They get places in the county out further where they don't get bothered as much. And there's a couple of them, I think, around this area. They're very shady. And I was walking through the parking lot, and I saw somebody peeking out the back door at me. What I actually did was, before I started the video, I actually went to the front door. It says, come in, the door's open. So I opened the door, I didn't see anybody in there, and I didn't really want to go in because I was feeling kind of creeped out. I thought it was like, I don't know, I was having these thoughts of going in there and never returning. Like Hotel California, you can check in but you can never leave. I don't know. Oh, that weirded me out. I don't know, I was having all these thoughts of going in and it's two big mafia guys coming out or something. I hope she's not going to call the cops though. All right, I don't think she's going to call the cops. All right, so I kind of wanted to walk around that building and get a shot of it. It's an interesting looking building. It has that Spanish-American look. Lately, I've been thinking to call them like Taco Bell buildings because the top of the roof sort of has like a little arch on it, and then sometimes it has like a hole in the top of the arch. Like where there would seem like there would be a bell. Like you'd imagine like in Mexico they have those buildings and they have a bell. And I'm not stereotyping because I've actually been to Nicaragua and Central America. Twice I've been there. And I've seen that architecture, and it's true. We're right near the airport too. The airport right across the street, so sometimes it gets noisy over here. And so far, I don't see anybody running after me. That was really interesting. So I was talking about going to Central America and stuff. And so I've been to the Dominican Republic a couple times too, which is very similar architecturally wise. It's funny, you know, it's funny when I do these vlogs. I have a couple like outlines in my head of how it's going to go. And then something weird happens. Like somebody talks to me or somebody interrupts something. And it just totally goes off. And I think that's why I end up coming up with the John Swift Live a title, because I record these live and almost when I do these, well, when I say when I do like a vlog, just a vlog, talking vlog, it's usually all one shot and I don't edit. And occasionally I have to edit because something weird happens or I think it's just, there's something in the video. So anyway, we're in this neighborhood, I think it's called Whitfield Estates. We're really close to it. It's a really old neighborhood, but I really like this area. There's this real cool wall. You know, there's a lot of like vacant spaces along here. Like from way, like a block down all the way down here, it's kind of like a park, but it looks like there actually, since there's a sidewalk, it actually looks like there was places here and there's like an empty lot there. And this place is really tranquil because I was down here last week before I went to Orlando. And this week I've been feeling really energetic, motivated for some reason. You know, I wish I could bottle that when I feel super motivated and I'm like, I just my mind's just running and I just need to catch up with it. I wish I could really bottle that. Look at this cool place across the street with the really beautiful banyan tree and stuff. It has those little block walls, like natural stone walls that they put all along there. Which you don't see that. It's not very common to see that. And that's kind of what I'm sitting on. It's kind of, well, this is kind of like a concrete, some kind of concrete block wall. Interesting. So the thoughts I was having this morning, I've been having a lot of, sometimes when I read something, it gets me sort of motivated, energized, and like the light bulb goes off in my head. Ooh, listen to this noise real quick. It's a plane taking off. It's amazing the volume of sound that comes from that, because right where that hill is back there, you can see sort of a hill past the trees, is where the planes end up taking off from. There's a giant wall there. It's like 30 or 40 feet tall over there with like a big sand berm, and the planes take off there. So I was really worried about having a really long vlog, and I just have so many things rattling around in my head today. So I'm trying to put it in a format. On the way out here, like I said, I was feeling really motivated, and I just have like a lot of thoughts, and some people would call that manic, but I would just call it energized with multiple thoughts running around my brain. One of the thoughts is that, I'm trying to figure out how to say this. One of the thoughts is, for most of my life, I've always thought you should trust your gut. And I don't know if you guys know that. I don't know if everybody's familiar with the theme, like, trust your gut. Because sometimes this video goes out. I see people that watch these videos from different countries. So sometimes I think about, like, how do you explain that, trust your gut? It's like your little voice inside your head. If you go to do something or you're trying to make a decision, for something, and sometimes you get a feeling, I don't know if it's specifically in your, is it really in your gut or is it in your head? But for some reason, I don't know, where did that come from? I guess I'll have to look that up on the internet. But anyway, that feeling for me is sort of a good or bad feeling. Like if you're going to buy a house and you have a feeling about either way, it's a good feeling or it's a bad feeling. And sometimes we just go with what makes sense, you know, if you're making a decision to buy a car or something, or to do a house, you're just making a logical decision. But we're not always listening to our gut or the little voice inside our head that's either saying no, don't do that, or yes, that's a good idea. And sometimes, you know, I feel here goes another plane right there, right past the trees. A lot of little private planes coming in there. You know, I've never flown on a, I would say like medium-sized plane, private plane. I always wanted to do that. I've flown on those 2- and 4-seater Cessnas, little planes like that, and I've flown on like the jets. I think once or twice I've flown on the commercial ones, but I always wanted to fly on like, say like a 10-person plane. You know, like, I don't know why. It's something I haven't done yet. I actually had a chance to fly in a helicopter too, so. Like I said, the brain is, without further ado, the brain is running about 120 miles an hour right now. So I have these multiple thoughts that I want to try to pack into here, because trusting your gut and seizing the day sometimes is a joint package. You know, seize the day. Do something today. Don't wait till tomorrow. You know, nobody really knows how long they're going to be on this earth, I don't think. You know, I don't, generally speaking, I don't know how long I'm going to be on this earth. I don't know if anybody else knows, unless you were sick or something like that and you sort of had an idea. But, you know what? Rather than just put the camera on me, I'm going to face it forward here and we're going to have a little talk. And you can see this really cool park that's right here, rather than having to look at me, because I know I'm not that great to look at, so I'll flip it around every once in a while. So, a friend of mine that I know, that I work with, is going into the Army. He's a really young guy, maybe 19. He's going into the Army, and I kind of want to have a talk with him about trusting your gut. Go with what you feel. Like, he had to make a big decision. He's going to go into the National Guard, I think, and he has to go to boot camp and all that. So, you know, I kind of want to tell him, you know, if you go to do something and you feel really bad about it, that you should do everything you can to not do that. Or, you know, if you, like, just like going in the Army, I didn't ask him if he had a good feeling or a bad feeling, but from, you know, being in my 40s and all this experience, life experience has taught me to trust your gut. I had a job one time, a job opportunity, to change jobs from working in a TV station to working in like a commercial TV production. And because it was paying more money and I was sick of where I was working, I took the job, but I didn't feel good about it when I did the interview. You know, hindsight being, you know, perfect. My gut was telling me strongly, this does not feel right. This does not feel right. And it didn't feel right. Excuse me. And then I didn't like the job. I pretty much hated it. I started dreading going in there. And it only lasted about 4 or 5 months. I just got sick of it and I had to get out of there. And, you know, after that I realized, you know, it wasn't just me being scared. It was me being... Sometimes it's hard to flesh out that feeling. Is it fear? Is it uncertainty that's your gut is telling you? You know, what is that feeling? But I think life experience teaches you to start trusting your gut. There's a really nice bunch of oak trees in this area. You know, this little lot here, I don't think it has a sign that said it's a park, but it's just like a sort of a big lot with a bunch of trees. I always wondered if there's houses here or not. But wouldn't it be great if you lived right next to this big, I'm calling it a park, but this piece of land or whatever. It's just a beautiful bunch of oak trees. Okay, so the other thing is, and there's a guy I watch on YouTube that I sort of draw some inspiration from. He's very positive. His name's Adam the Woo. You can look up Adam the Woo on YouTube. He seems like a very positive person, and he's got a couple friends that actually do YouTube too, and he always just seems constantly positive, constantly looking to the future, motivated, and I sort of have to draw some motivation from him. And I think everybody in their life draws motivation from somewhere. You know, I always had like idols like you know, Van Halen. I really liked the group Van Halen, and so early in my career, I played music and stuff and wanted to be like that and tried to mirror that somewhere. And then I think Van Halen projected somewhat of a positive image. They weren't about doing drugs, and they projected an image of like sex and stuff, but it wasn't always necessarily, you know, drugs and whatever. Negative, not so much like Motley Crue, the Bad Boys, or somebody like that, or, you know, a lot of other bands. I'm old, so I can't think of a reference that's like bad. You know, like Led Zeppelin, in a way, had a little bit of a dark connotation to them, rather than just all positive. I'm saying that the perception was that they had a dark perception, but so yeah, I'm trying to get to the meat of the subject. So yeah, he was talking about Adam the Woo, the guy on YouTube, was talking about doing what makes you feel good, trying to search for things in life that make you feel good, whether it's where you're working or what you're doing or what you do when you're not working or how you play. And he's very fortunate, a fortunate guy, that he took some chances and decided to go on the road, quit his job, get out of his apartment and not have a home and go and just explore the country, which is just fascinating to me. And he did it with like barely any money too. He would just took whatever money he had and, you know, bought food and gas and would go out. And he said that many times in his thing, it's the best thing in his life that he ever did. And sometimes when we take a leap, look at this stuff. There's some stuff on the side of the road over here. That's why I was walking over here. It's like a jewelry cabinet with some like little jewelry cases. There's like a, it always makes me wonder. Okay, it's not open, so I can't look in there, but sometimes I don't necessarily always go, but I'm just curious about what this stuff is, because it looks like somebody lived here and either they're having a big garage sale or they just got kicked out. I'm not sure, but just a bunch of stuff here. Kind of looks like they still live here, but maybe it's spring cleaning and fall. Did I mention it's cold out today? For some reason it just got warmer. All right, so stay on subject. Do what you like, okay? So you say, I can't do what I like. I have to have a job. I have kids. I have a family. You know, I got a car payment. I got a home payment and all this stuff. Yes, that's true. You may not be able to do what you want, but whoops, almost stepped out in front of a car. Don't do that. Whatever you do, don't step out in front of a car. And that has sort of a broad connotation. It's actually getting hot right now for some reason, maybe because I'm walking. Do what you want, or try to do what you want. And Adam, for some, you know, for intensive purposes, wasn't married, didn't have kids as far as I know, and he just went on the road a couple years ago. And he is very popular on YouTube. He's living in California. He has a huge body of work where he went all over the country to famous sites and did a lot of cool movie locations too. So you should check out his site. He's got some really great stuff on there. And I draw inspiration from that because of what he's been able to accomplish on like zero money. He had like a donate. This is kind of another little park over. He had like a donate icon on his website. And in a way, I take inspiration by somewhat copying him in the style of video that he does, but not necessarily. I try not to, you know, do the same things that he does, but it's like he's been able to be very successful media-wise by basically just being himself and doing videos, being himself and sort of having like a reality show. Like he has a video every day. And so I'm trying to say that I'm not copying him, but I am, maybe I'm emulating him. I don't know. I just think it's a neat premise that he set up where he's done his own reality show without anybody but himself. I mean, he shoots the video himself. Here comes another plane. He shoots the video himself. He edits them himself. There's the plane. It's a little twin engine jet there. It's kind of neat how it comes so low over this neighborhood. Maybe it's not neat for them. Look at this cool banyan tree. This would be a cool place to shoot some photos, is in this park area. You know, I haven't noticed the street signs, but it's really near Whitfield. If you know where Sam Ash is in Sarasota, Whitfield and 301. Wow, this is a great tree. I always wanted to climb a tree like this. But most of the places I see them are usually people's yards. Let's see, there's a mattress there. But what a cool tree. Look at that tree. Fantastic, isn't it? It just looks like the ultimate treehouse tree because it's so broad. Okay. So, another thing I wanted to touch on is along with that thing, I have like a little string of themes. Like my outline is like, you know, trust your gut, do what you like, and part of it is, should say, don't care about what other people think. Unless it's like your parents, and then sometimes you have to care what they think, but. The other day I ordered a Burt Reynolds book, and at one time I went on YouTube and looked up a lot of Burt Reynolds interviews, because I've always admired him as an actor. He always seems like he was a very cool guy, macho guy, you know, always seemed like he had hot chicks and married to, and back in the 70s, he was basically the number one box office draw, you know, for like 10 years. Like everything he put out was number one movie. So look at this interesting tree, with this leaning branch. Leaning branch kind of makes you want to get on it because it's so low. Okay, I'm on the branch now. My gut told me to get on this branch. So Burt Reynolds just put out a book before, I noticed. It might have been in the 90s or something, before one of his really good movies came out. And then he put out another one recently, and he's been looking kind of a little bit on the sick side. If you've seen anything in the news or something, he did like a Comic-Con, and I believe he lives in Florida too. I'm not exactly sure where, but I heard he has like an actor's studio and stuff. So, jumping down from the tree. See, I scratched that off my bucket list. I wanted to jump into a tree, so I did that. So, Burt Reynolds, I ordered the book on Amazon, and then it had a free preview. So I read like a chapter forward of the chapter, and it was actually by John Voight. And one of the reasons why I like Burt Reynolds is because of the movie Deliverance. And it has always fascinated me. It always used to be on TV when I was in my 20s. For some reason, I would always flip on TV, like TBS would always be running Deliverance. And if you haven't seen that movie, this is the second time in a video that I've actually mentioned this. It's four guys that decide to go on a canoe trip. I'm stopping so I can concentrate a little bit better. And one of them is a macho survivalist type dude who's like a bow hunter. And one guy is like a suburbanite father. Another guy is like his business partner. There's a third guy that I can't remember his name. So it's John Voight, Ned Beatty, and the third guy, and I still couldn't remember his. He did a lot of movies. He did RoboCop, and he played like a lot of bad guys in movies. Ronnie Cox, okay, Ronnie Cox. And what was the other one? Burt Reynolds, John Voight, and the third guy. Well, the famous scene is that you hear, if you do it, the reference is where the guy gets raped in the woods, which is not what the whole movie is about. The whole movie is about some guys getting out of their comfort zone and going out. I'm not sure if it's supposed to be North Carolina. I thought maybe they shot the scenes in North Carolina or Georgia. I guess it's not really that important, but it's that area of the South where there's a river. It's supposed to be this really awesome river, and they're in canoes. They're going down the river. They end up stopping for some reason. They run into these guys who are hunting with the rifles, and they get kind of basically held up by these guys. Ooh, look at that over there. Almost down the street, it actually looks like a little park down there. Maybe it's somebody's property. I think I jogged in another vlog, my Thanksgiving vlog. I was actually jogging right down the street down here. Kind of wanted to find a spot where there's no people, where this park is right here, because it's such a pretty. Okay, let's shoot more park video and less me video. You know, it's like totally dead here. Today is Thursday. No, today's Friday. Sorry, happy Friday. Sorry, I should have started that with happy Friday. And look at this old school drain thing that's made out of bricks. That should tell you how old this is. And I always say it's 20s or 30s, but maybe it could have been made in the 50s, but it's like so old school. Usually you would see concrete, but it's all bricked. I don't know if you call that a cistern or what that is. I think I'm gonna sneeze now. You ever had that sneeze? You feel it coming, you start thinking about it, and it goes away. Sometimes you squeeze your nose, and then it comes back suddenly. It suddenly comes back. Okay, so what are we at now? Let's see, get this where I can see. Is that 24 minutes? 24 minutes, 51. Okay. Just kidding. This might be a record vlog, so everybody just tighten your seatbelt. I have a lot of things on my brain. I'm always afraid if I break this up into another vlog that I won't be able to articulate what I'm thinking, what the things that I wanted to get out on a personal level, especially when I'm just sort of in this philosophical, I guess, mood where a lot of a lot of thoughts about life and what I'm doing right now are coming through my head, and I'm just thinking about what I want to do in the future and stuff like that. Okay, we're going to look at Moore Park here instead of looking at me. So, back to the Burt Reynolds thing. So, there's a fresh dog doo-doo right there. Signs of life there. Since I haven't seen anybody, except for the lady who peeked out from the building. So, the Burt Reynolds. Okay, back to the Burt Reynolds. See, I should edit that, because there was a big... Sometimes I will edit those little spaces out. So he did Deliverance. That was really... Something in that movie really caught a hold of me. I have actually been whitewater rafting near that area of wherever in North Carolina. I've actually been whitewater rafting once. I did that when I was young. And it was very intriguing, because I think a lot of people take that on as a challenge where you jump in a rubber boat, you go downstream, you don't know what's going to happen. You're paddling for your life. There's water splashing all over. The way we did it is we had 1 foot in the boat and 1 foot outside on the edge, like it was a rubber boat with those tubes on the side. It's crazy. And my sister went with me too, I believe, on that trip. We were staying in Montreat, and we drove and went down that river. It's really crazy, but it was crazy fun. We were all wet and cold. Wet and cold, but it was still a blast. One of those things you're not really sure what's going to happen, just like these vlogs. Just never really sure when you start rolling this camera. You're never sure what's going to happen. So, John Voight does a foreword to Burt Reynolds' book, which just was released, I think, this month. He's been promoting it. About how Burt Reynolds and he were shooting a scene for the movie where they had just gotten to where they were going to launch the canoes, and they needed somebody to drive their trucks back from where the starting point in the river is back to where they're going to end up. They need, you know, it was going to be like, I don't know if it was 10 miles or 15 miles or something like that. So they wanted to hire some local guys, and the guys were real, you know, I hate to use the term like hillbillies, but that's basically what they were. It was hillbillies. And they were racing to the point where they're going to put the canoes in. And Burt Reynolds is such a tough guy, he was racing. And he said, for real, Burt Reynolds was doing the driving stunts. And when they took off, John Voight said he was like pretty much petrified, because Burt Reynolds was driving like a maniac. And he was supposed to be racing the other car through the woods, through the trees. And he was... supposed to cut the truck off. Well, the way he says it, it doesn't sound like they did a lot of planning. You know, maybe there was more planning involved, but it didn't sound like there was a ton of planning. Another vacant lot there. I always wonder why there's these lots. There'll be homes and homes and homes, and all of a sudden there's a vacant lot there. That's weird to me. I wonder what that is. That's something for a different day. So, John Voight and him swing around a corner, and they hit a giant hole and fly up in the air. And they said they about put their heads through the windshield during that stunt. And I think he said he just learned a lot about acting and a lot about life that day. And shooting Deliverance with Burt Reynolds, who was just a guy who would just ready, set, go. And John Voight was more of a guy who liked to think about things and contemplate things. So it's interesting that way about life. And that's why I think Burt Reynolds always came through on his films, because I think as a person, that's who he was, and it always kind of came through in his movies, how he was just a guy that was just ready to just do it. You know, let's not think about it. You know, we're just going to do it. And coincidentally, I feel sometimes like I do that, like I'm very spontaneous person, where I don't do a lot of planning. I don't sit and think, I'm going to do this on Friday, I'm going to do this on Wednesday. I usually wake up, see how I feel, and if if I feel good and I feel like I have something to talk about, I'll do a vlog. And if I don't really have much on my mind that day, that's usually the day I won't shoot something, or I'll try to shoot something that has a subject matter where we can just talk about, this is what, you know, this is a house, this is an abandoned place, this is something, this is some shopping place. So, but when I'm really have a lot of thoughts rolling, I think I should just, you know, go for broke and stick it on tape. Then that way I don't have any regrets later. So we go back to trusting your gut, do what you like to do, and what was the third thing? Read a Burt Reynolds book. Okay, yeah, so if you're writing this down, trust your gut, do what you like, and read a Burt Reynolds book. No, the third thing, there was a third thing, but now I forgot. Okay, the third thing is don't forget number three. Just write that down. The sun's coming out a little bit, I can tell. You know, when it was about 60-something degrees when I got out here. I think when I got here, it was about 11:30 in the afternoon, or in the morning, or whatever. So, that's what I want to pass that on, because I saw that vlog, I think it was this week, on the Adam the Woo thing, and he was talking about, do what you like to do. And I cannot tell you the steps to do, to getting to a place in your life where you're doing what you want to do. I've heard many people say, like, you know, and I hate, okay, I dislike motivational speakers, because they come up and they tell you, this is easy. You do these 10 steps to getting to financial freedom, or you do these 10 steps, or you do these 5 steps. And it doesn't work for everybody like that. Sometimes it's a matter of timing. Sometimes it's a matter of life situation. Sometimes it's a matter of money, or what opportunity. And I'm just passing on sort of a paying it forward message from Adam, who is saying, try to figure out what you want to do in life and steer in that direction. For me, my journey has been from going from a full-time job in a hospital, quitting around 2013, to going to school full-time, for about 6 months, and then I started going part-time, and I started working part-time, and I started doing YouTube around 2013. Not this vlog, but my other channel, Mr. John Swift 200, I started that around, doing a lot of videos around 2013. So, you know, and I didn't have a lot of success back then, but 2 years later, it has grown a lot, and I'm somewhere around 650 subscribers on that, and somewhere about 1.5 million views, which is pretty good. But I never would have thought that starting out, and that's why sometimes you take these leaps of faith. You sort of just jump off the cliff face, hoping that the water is deep enough. And there's so many sayings like no risk, no reward, stuff like that. And I think those sayings come about because there is a measure of truth in that. And right now, I feel like I'm in a really good place. You know, I'm not making the money that I would like to make. Not that I want to make $100,000 a year, but I would just like to be in a place where I could just comfortably afford my bills. But the good thing is that I'm in a place where I'm walking by a hotel. I don't even know what this place is. It says banquet meeting over there. I'm in a place like I just feel good about what I'm doing on a daily basis. I work at a place where I counselor for kids, and I do some volunteering at a elementary school, which that just seems like nothing but good as far as I'm, it feels nothing, but it's the way it feels. It's not something you can put on a piece of paper. So I'm just passing on and encouraging people to steer toward your dream. I know you can't, people that have families and they have obligations, you can't just go out and quit your job and then just say, well, I'm going to do something else today. I'm going to sell t-shirts for a living. And some people do that. It's all about just how simply you can live sometimes. Like right now, I don't have cable television. I have an antenna television, but with digital TV, it's basically like having somewhat cable because you get 20 something channels or 30 channels or whatever it is. I have decided to pare down on my bills. I don't think I've had cable television for 10 years, maybe even longer than that. And it's like, well, how do you get along without cable television? Just learn to live with that way. I mean, I get network TV stations and stuff like that, but most people have gotten rid of their home phones. I got rid of my home phone. I only have the cell phone. You know, God bless my girlfriend. She helped me through a lot of this transitional phase where I had to go to school, and then I got out of school, and then I had to look for a job. But I'm just really thankful, you know. I did the Thanksgiving vlog the Tuesday before Thanksgiving last week, and I forgot to really say what I'm thankful for, and I should have done that. I was thankful for my friends, but where are we at time here? I'm shooting for about 30 minutes, so we're past that now. 35, is that what it says? One of my goals should be to get a bigger phone so I could see. It's in the 30 region, so. You know, it would be neat if I could take it and edit it and make it, speed it up so it was only like 20 minutes, but. So, I'm going to wind this down, reiterating the three steps to being in a happy place. Number one, let's all say it together. Number one is do what you like. Or try to do what you like. Number two is, what did we say it was? Buy a Maserati. It's a good thing my memory is not this bad in real life. It's only bad when I'm on the camera. It's only really bad when I'm doing this. Number three was, you know what, I already said it, so you can rewind it. And number four, three is, number two is, you know what that is because I already said it. Number three is, get a Burt Reynolds book, get the autobiography, help Burt out. I don't know how he is financially, but. So, I just want to say hello to all my friends that watch, and my extended YouTube family, my Facebook family people. Now that we established we're family, look at this cool yard right here. I love yards that have like a lot of plants and stuff. Really cool. So I'm gonna say goodbye, guys. Have a great week. And just contemplate that a little bit. Find something you like to do. You know, are you in a place where you are doing something you like to do? No, but it's for your family. And you know, if you have to switch jobs and make less money, is that worth it? How you doing? Is that worth it? There's a guy over here, probably looking at me saying, is he doing what he, he's probably saying that right now. Is that guy doing what he likes to do? And I would say, yes, I am doing what I like to do. Thank you. Does he have his rocker? Yes. You know, I had some more subjects to talk about, but I'm going to have to put that in the next blog. So guys, have a great week, and we're almost to the weekend here. We'll see you. I don't know if I'm going to be doing like more vlogs, but I'm headed to the Frisbee store to buy a Frisbee. That's all I can tell you for now. Love you guys. Have a great weekend. We'll see you in the next vlog. See ya. Oh, one more thing. Check my Facebook because I had put a new video on this weird bike that I saw on Facebook. So go check that out too on John Swift Live on Facebook. We'll see you later.